Good afternoon, guys. My name is Alena Shautsova. I'm an immigration attorney from Brooklyn, New York. In today's video, I would like to talk to you about prosecutorial discretion, and it seems that it's back. According to some media resources, on May 27th, the main immigration prosecutor sent out a memo stating that now immigration prosecutors will enjoy a discretion to dismiss or delay one's case if respondent meets certain qualifications. So we're going to talk about these qualifications and if you need to apply for it, how the process of determining whether a person's case should be dismissed or delayed is taking place, or determination as to who qualifies for this new great prosecutorial discretion. Thank you very much for joining me. First of all, guys, if you have not subscribed to my channel or you're not still somehow not a follower of my Facebook page, please correct that and join my channel and my Facebook page. You also can participate in live Q&A for free. For example, if you have one question, you do not want to spend money on a consultation, it would be a great opportunity for you to ask a lawyer a question that you have. So let's talk about the prosecutorial discretion. As I said, just recently we learned that it seems that Obama-style prosecutorial discretion is back. This discretion does not even require a lawyer to submit a request for it, unlike during the Obama time. The guidelines to the prosecutor states that they on their own have to assess one's case. And if the case meets certain qualifications, they may exercise their discretion to delay or dismiss the case. What are those qualifications, one may ask? Those are the following qualifications. First of all, proceedings may be terminated for somebody who is a long-term green card holder and they received their green card at a young age. For example, a person received their green card when he or she was one. Later in life, some things happened. Perhaps there was a small criminal conviction, and now the person ended up in removal proceedings. Well, the prosecutor may take that factor into consideration, the factor that the person has been a long-term green card holder, and terminate the case. Another group of people are the people with serious health conditions, also elderly or minor, meaning that respondent is a child. Happens more often than you think. During the Trump administration, kids as young as one year old were placed in removal proceedings, something that really, really should not be happening. Pregnant ladies, victims of domestic violence or other serious crimes may also be qualified for this prosecutorial discretion. People who have military family members, not just those who are parents of a military family members, but if you are anyhow related to a military member, you can highlight that fact before the prosecutor and they may use it to close your case. People who are likely to be granted status through a family, immigration, or TPS. We're talking about people who can adjust before USCIS, let's say when their relative becomes a US citizen or reaches certain age. It would be great if the prosecutors would finally terminate these cases and would just simply allow people to adjust their status before USCIS, just like it was before, 4 years prior to Trump administration. Also, people who represent significant asset to a state or federal government. Perhaps we're talking about business people who can be holding government contracts. You'll be surprised how many immigrants developed some serious businesses in the United States that employ hundreds of people, and yet these people do not have status in the United States and sometimes even are in removal proceedings. So that would be awesome help for those people. Again, prosecutors are encouraged to look at such factors as public safety and national security. It's very important because basically, even if you have a serious criminal conviction but do not represent a public safety concern and do not pose any security risk, you may hope for the prosecutors to exercise their discretion for you. And also factors such as family ties in the United States, work history, status as a victim or witness to a crime may be taken into consideration. So, as I mentioned, no need to apply for it, but I think it would be prudent to do so. Just because the prosecutor may not have some relevant factors in front of him or her when they're making their determination, it says that the prosecutors should make their assessments at the very beginning of the case and throughout the case. So it's possible to apply for this even later in the case. That's exactly how it was before with the during the Obama administration. And I think if you guys are in removal proceedings, you should check with your attorney if you can hope for this discretion. Also, by the way, people who are caregivers, we're talking about parents of the US citizens, or perhaps you are taking care of a parent who is a US citizen, you also may hope for prosecutorial discretion. Very, very important. Discretion, as is mentioned by the media, can come into various forms: to delay the case, perhaps administratively close it, right? And to dismiss or perhaps terminate it. This is something that we all were waiting for, and now we just need to receive affirmative confirmation that administrative closure and termination are going to be back as a result of this memo. So thank you very much for watching. I'm going to provide more updates as soon as they become available. And again, like, share this video, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you soon.